What's your bolts in your mouth?
Experiments. Experiments really crazy.
Okay, next is fire department.
Yep.
Hello.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I just want to give you guys an update. The gas conversion at the firehouse is going well. They converted one boiler today and the hot water heater. They're going to be doing the conversion on the second boiler tomorrow morning. And that should be completed. Next week, they're going to be doing the makeup air unit and some of the, and then start doing some of the small equipment like the dryers, the stoves upstairs and stuff like that. So hopefully the next couple weeks will be 100% converted over to gas. But we are running on natural gas right now at the firehouse for one of the boilers and the hot water heater, which is good.
Mm-hmm. So, and now it's more expensive.
And another update, is there a truck in the works? Do I remember?
Yes, Engine 7. Engine 7, we're actually, myself, the assistant chief, and the lieutenant are going to be going out to Minnesota Thursday and Friday of next week to do a pre-conference on the truck. And the truck will be delivered to us 300 days from the date of the contract when it was signed. So we should have a new engine to replace Engine 7, hopefully next year at this time.
So then this item, Engine 7, that you have in here, it's all set?
It's all set. Engine 7 in the budget's all set. Okay. So what we did is we took the price of the truck minus the trade, and we just spaced it out over the next few years. I went over it with Tony.
Yeah, we'll adjust the, we get closer, we can adjust some of the lease, the financing for the lease to,
Great.
We approve that.
I don't know how it goes in your packet. I mean, we're a pretty big department. The other thing I want to talk about is, as when we go on with the trucks, and we're going to go through each truck, but I don't know if it makes sense to continue to do a capital budget like this, where we're going to keep showing you the trucks, or come up, we could talk about each trucks each year, but maybe we come up with a truck fund, not necessarily tied to one specific truck, since I think what we need to do is we need to start putting some money aside each year, even if we're not buying a truck. So when a truck comes up like number 7, we just don't get hit with one big payment, and we're going to have multiple trucks coming up in multiple years, which is going to cost quite a bit of money. So I don't know if that's something you guys want to entertain or we want to talk about, or...
Brought that up last year, so I certainly
willing to entertain that.
We would feel better if there were an apparatus reserve and money reserved every year. We recognize that that's your all's responsibility to figure that out. But I think, you know, Sean's point is rather than asking for a reserve for each specific, type of vehicle, I think it's just a general apparatus.
I mean, we'd still come through with the regular process when we're looking to purchase a truck. We'd still show you why we would need to purchase it and everything else, but the money would be in there.
I think it makes sense. I think what I would like to see was, because you're, Sean, you just said there's a few trucks that are going to be coming. Mm-hmm. You could spread that out for us. And then
I actually have that. I actually ran over here and I left that paper back at the firehouse that has all the apparatus on it. The year of the truck, and then the scheduled replacement of the apparatus.
From there, we could compute a number each year that kind of would make sense.
Right, and as we go through this budget right now,
yeah,
we'll see the trucks that are in the six-year capital plan that are coming up in the next 6 years.
Okay. Yeah, and I do agree, an apparatus truck fund, something I brought up last year, therefore, as your priorities change, and they do, an engine goes down, a truck goes down that you don't expect, isn't always because of age or mileage or hours. And of course, at that time, as you said, you would still have to come to us to approve the individual truck or apparatus that's needed, but at least we can make it a little easier to maneuver.
Correct.
So Engine 3 and Engine 9 are the ones to which you refer that I see?
Engine 3 is a 1989 FMC attack pumper. It's actually the backup attack engine. When Engine 2 goes out for service, that's the truck that we would use to go fight a house fire if we need to. That's also a truck that goes to brush fires, wire down calls, CO calls, just a bunch of different...
Those are the ones you say are coming up
Yes, yes. Engine 3, actually, Engine 3, this is the truck that we put, I think, roughly $30,000 into about 3 years ago. We had some body rot on it, and we were looking to get, we were looking at that point to get another 8-9 years out of the truck. We do have some issues with this truck, which we're trying to overcome right now. I mean, the pump back in the 80s, they didn't offer all stainless steel. It was all steel, so the lines for the pump are actually corroding, so we're trying to figure out, we're replacing the line as it goes down, but to get into the actual pump and change a line, it's not like a regular 3/4-inch line where you unscrew and you put a new one on. This, the whole pump has to basically come out and be replumbed for that one section, and the piece has to be custom made, since all these trucks are really, when you talk about fire trucks, all of them are basically made from the ground up, so everything's cut different, and it's not like a standard item on any apparatus, any fire apparatus.
And that's why you have to go to a pre-conference.
You got it. So basically, we go to a pre-conference, and during the pre-conference, we go over every single nut, bolt, bend, gauge, lever, everything that truck will do, exactly where the plumbing's going to come, how it's all going to work, where we want different levers for discharges, cross lays. It all gets done there. It's actually
in the
two-day.
Minnesota in December part. That was just,
you could come. It's a little chilly out there right now.
Actually, I do have a question. Can I just follow up? I guess I should have asked this a couple of years ago. When you get a truck, is the town of Woodbridge the actual title holder to the truck?
Yes.
Okay. And does it come under the town's general insurance?
Insurance, yeah.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Okay. So, Engine 3, we figured to start replacing an FY20. Any questions on number 3?
Nope.
Okay. Engine 7 is pretty self-explanatory. We approved that last year, and it's in the works. Engine 9 is the sister truck to Engine 7. Engine 9 was purchased back in 1995. In FY18, it's going to be 23 years old, which number 7 was 23, 24 years old, where we started having issues with, and it should be on the schedule to be replaced. Not saying we can't get 25 years out of it, but we're coming up to that life expectancy. And per NFPA 1901, apparatus should be replaced after 25 years. So we are an NFPA state also. Engine 9 responds, it's the sister truck to number 7. It also responds to all motor vehicle accidents. It's the RIT truck, where if we go to another town, we take an RIT team with us. That truck goes, and it goes to quite a bit.
Rapid intervention team.
Right, sorry.
We were called on that to Orange last week. We got an RIT call.
What's the next one on your list? So,
well, you know, let's just, well, the ladder truck, I think, you know, we've...
The ladder truck, we really need to, that's our next priority for apparatus. We really need to replace that truck. I know there's some discussion on why we would need it, or the length of the truck, or the length of the ladder. We need a 100-foot ladder in this town. I mean, back in the 1970s, when Engine 6 was designed, it was built for the town back in the 70s, where you had single family homes, you didn't have any big houses. Right now,
and the footprint of the high school is much smaller.
Right, the footprint of the high school we had right now is 288,000 square feet. We didn't have Research Drive back then. We didn't have the three nursing homes where you need that to get patients out possibly. We didn't have all the banks we had, and residents in the town. The residences in the town have grown big. We're talking over 5,000 square foot homes. We're talking truss construction, so it is. It's not as safe for firefighters to get up on a truss roof once it's been burning, because by the time you get there, the gusset plate of the truss has already been compensated by the heat of the fire. So. Steel bends at 1,000 degrees, so if the fire's been going, that's going to be the weakest point. Instead of conventional framing, where conventional framing, you have to burn through the entire timber to have a collapse. But the height of the buildings is a concern. Even just, we'll take the high school or take any building, you got to also compensate when you have, we're supposed to be 1.5 times back out of the collapse zone when we stick a ladder, we put any apparatus, we're supposed to be 1.5 times. If there's a collapse, the truck's not going to get demolished, nobody's going to get hurt or killed. But you also have to consider the sidewalks that are now in front of these buildings along with landscaping and everything else. So you could be 25 feet away from a building before you could actually even position the truck. And so it adds to the length of the truck. So we're looking at a roughly 100-foot aerial truck, in which we believe we need to start financing now. But just to give you a heads up, to design a ladder truck, and you saw what we went through with number 7, it took us 10 months to design. We're talking 6 to 10 months to design an aerial. And then once we go through the bidding process and get approvals, we're looking at a year of build time before we even get the truck. So even if we ordered it today, we're probably 2 years before we see an aerial in this town.
I have a question. Sean, where is the nearest ladder truck to us?
Orange has one on the Post Road. It's a 100-foot aerial. Mm-hmm. The problem in the fire service is once you show up to a fire, you start dropping lines, and we could talk about, say, the high school. High school is probably the perfect situation, right? School's going on, we start dropping lines, we hit hydrants, we're laying in. To get a ladder truck in 15 to 20 minutes after the initial call comes in, even lights and siren coming off the Post Road is going to be a challenge. Just to get it even close to the building and to do any type of rescue is probably going to be nil.
In other words, to have it coming in late in the call rather than at the beginning of the call is very difficult and really minimal value. I mean, you've seen, and some of you have seen, the fires, the recent fire scenes and the structure fires, which are small house fires, and what the scene looks like in terms of how crowded it can get. Once all our other trucks are in place and fighting the fire, it's too late. You can't count on bringing a ladder truck in there. So if you need it, you need it to respond to the initial alarm. And the high school is a good example, because even though in most spots the high school isn't that tall, it's also very wide. I mean, the building itself, so that we can anticipate needing to use that ladder truck to reach deep into the building rather on top of the building rather than just the shorter distance.
So I can't stress enough how important a ladder truck is. The ladder truck's going to be 40 years old. It's done what it needs to do. It's just not a reliable piece anymore. The ladder's not big enough. It has a 500-gallon water tank on it, a 1,250-gallon pump. I understand it's a lot of money, but it's something we really need to do.
Okay, the second is an assistant chief vehicle. We put money away for that.
You funded that last year, I think $25,000,
right. And this is the second installment.
This is the second installment for that.
What kind of vehicle would this be?
It's going to probably be either an Explorer or a Tahoe. That vehicle has 160,000 miles on it.
This is 160.
Yeah. The air packs, this is something we went through
a while ago.
We don't have a choice. That we have to do every 15 years.
Fire hose replacement, the same
thing. Fire hose replacement is the same deal.
Well, what about this main radio system? That's total 100,000?
We're going to
discuss that in 1 second. Can we just go on to the storage building first, and then we'll come back to the main radio system?
No, let's think about the last.
Okay. The storage building. You want to leave the storage building?
Yeah, just go. Again, we're all pretty much confused about all these radios. So,
all right. We're going to make it a little easier. Okay. Here's a letter from Julie Reibel. I talked to Julie today. She was able to type up a letter.
This is the Julie from Northeast.
This is Julie from Northeast.
If she comes here and talks to you, you won't understand anything she's talking about.
Well, that's apparent.
I know.
We got all kinds of.
Julie is our head, basically, person that we deal with the radios. We deal with Motorola. Julie helps us out. Julie guides us in the right direction. She explains what she can explain. Sometimes you'll understand her. If you understand the concept early and you stay with her, then you'll get it. If you get lost, you're going to get lost in the first 30 seconds and you're going to sit there and daydream. But,
back up a little and sort of bring the.
She'll try and you'll try to get it and you'll. It's just. It's a. No hope. I talked to Julie today. The fire concern is, and there's two parts of the radio system. There's the simulcast radio system, which are the three sites that we have in town, the three transmit sites that we have in town. Okay? So there's one at the transfer station, there's one at the tower at the PD, which you see as you drive by, and there's one on the Sal Ward building down in the flats.
And this is just for the fire department?
This is fire and police.
Police, okay.
Okay. The radio system handles fire and police, okay? Does two channels. It's a two-channel system. What we need to do is the radio system needs to be replaced. When I talk to Julie, she says an FY18. The system itself, the brains of the system in FY18, because the parts are obsolete. The radio system becomes obsolete in 2018, meaning the system's already obsolete now. So what happens is when a system goes obsolete, they usually carry parts or they'll support parts for 5 years. After that, the system is no good anymore, and it's basically a crapshoot whether you're going to be able to get parts or you can't get parts. And there's certain things that you're going to have to replace. So you're basically going to be throwing good money after bad to try to put a Band-Aid fixes onto the system until you have enough money to replace the system. She recommends replacing the system in FY18. The radio console, which does dispatches fire, dispatches police, dispatches the medic, which is actually right now at the police department, needs to be replaced now. The cost of the console is rough.
Can I just stop for one second? This is the same console that Ray just told us doesn't need to be replaced.
I think the whole system is really, yes.
Same one.
Yes.
Well, what he said was, if I understand, was that he doesn't want to replace it till the building.
Yeah.
Gets
yeah,
I'm right. Saying because of the walls and all this other stuff.
That
so
may be, but
that's,
he said it doesn't need to be replaced now.
Okay.
For whatever his reasoning is, that's fine. But he said okay. It doesn't now. Chief's.
So chief are we talking about the same,
same console.
Which is located, where is this console?
Police department.
It's in the police department. So this 100,000 you're talking about is going to be in the police department?
No.
Well,
this 100,000.
That's the best part.
I'm going to tell you, this 100,000, when I did the budget, right, I figured on, after everybody's talked and this and that, I figured the police department putting a $600,000 radio console into their capital budget. It didn't happen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the fire commission. I'm going to have the fire commission put $600,000 back into this budget and amend our capital budget so it shows a radio console. If that radio console goes down and they don't have the parts, they're going to come back, or somebody's going to come back, whether it be them, whether it be us, or whether it be somebody, and say, we need to come up with $600,000 to replace the radio console. Whether you do the building or not, the console needs to be replaced.
Okay, let me back up 1 second. That was, I was trying to get that, that's why I think we obviously have to talk to Julie. And I am concerned, because I have heard concern that this, in some people's opinion, sounds like yours as well, it could go anytime. And sooner, probably rather than later. So that being said, the little confusion that we're having and that Matt was just asking about, this console, which currently is in the police department, if we replace it, it could be in either, because you have connected, when they built the new firehouse.
The new radio consoles, you can actually have multiple stations. So you can have a station at the firehouse and a station at the PD.
So the console itself could conceivably be in either building, because don't you have underground connectivity?
We do have underground connectivity. We do.
It'd be easier
to stick the console right now at the PD, and we could actually run and put a console at the firehouse, and we could put two consoles at the PD. We can do that for that month, for that amount of money.
My point of asking that question is, part of the, what seemed like Ray was telling us was they really wanted to combine this with the building. But if the console, which is really a rack of what looks like computers,
digital servers,
a rack system, not very big, if the console can actually be housed, at least even temporarily, at the fire department, then we don't really need to worry about the timing of the building of the police department for the console of the radio.
It's easier. It's easier to put the console, the brain of it, at the PD because all our connections are over there.
Okay.
It'd be an added cost if we could. We could put it at the firehouse. It'd be an added cost to do that. It'd be easier to put it at the PD. Then we can have multiple. We can have multiple sites with it. The bottom line is this console needs to be replaced. And the number I was talking to Julie is the number's around 600.
I would suggest that that the police chief, that Ray and the fire chief and Julie, come before the Board of Selectmen and they talk about this.
I agree.
Because you're getting conflicting stories, and everybody may be correct. Okay?
Right. So
all right. Well, I think it's best that you have all parties together, and then we get one story.
I said that last year. That
you did say that last year.
You guys got to get together, put together a proposal, and try and get us to understand.
Because
I get totally confused with radios.
Well, this
really
part
don't.
Is clear. Please be free to contact me should you have any information. That part I
so, understand. So again, back, you're saying $600,000 for the console? And the console that we're talking about for $600,000 is located in the police department.
Mm-hmm.
So if that were done,
it is now.
Does this $100,000 still need to be spent?
Yeah. This, I've been putting this in the budget for the last 4 years.
So what is this?
This is part of the actual radio system. This is
which would
hook
into
this
console?
This is the tower sites. Forget the console now. This is the tower sites.
I'd like to second what Andy said.
This is the tower sites. So there's two parts of the radio. Like I said, you have the console. Which
we
kind of
need a radio 101 course.
From but you I have a console where you push the button.
So this is
to
upgrade
hello.
The simulcast.
Radio,
this is to upgrade the simulcast system.
Yep.
Sean, but does it do any good without the new console?
Does right. this do any good? Yeah, this you have to do.
So you
in
could
have
this would get it. This stands on its own and does what it's
got
to do.
Gives
you
a better
signal. With or without a new console.
Well, the issue is the new console can support our analog system now.
Listen, the total price of the project is around $1.7 million to replace to upgrade the radio system and to replace the console. It's around 1.7. If you take that, there's two major components. There's this component, which is the radio system, and then you have the console.
Yes.
Sean.
Yes.
What is the system?
It's the actual tower sites where the tower, the antenna sticks up in the air, and in these rooms, there's repeaters, there's units, they're called quantars. It's like a server,
of course
right? Well, no, they're called they're like servers, and they transmit and receive signals.
So when they send back,
right? Yeah, instead of right.
Yes, I mean, you got to like. I mean, it's not clear to me. In other words, it's in the fire department. It's in the police department. Do they talk?
This system is designed to bring all the departments together,
except for public works.
Okay.
No, the new system would bring public works together.
Right. That's what I
bring public works together. I think that would be, again, I think I go back to my original suggestion. And then let's resolve it once and for all.
Yeah, and I also, just not to interrupt, but my thought, and the reason I asked Sean that question a minute ago was, you know, Ray said, obviously you want to do it in one time, but also there was a cost if we needed the radio system but put it in first, the problem is we'd have a cost to move it. Well, if we need a radio system, but it could be put over, and I understand what Sean's saying, there would be a cost to move it to the fire department, but if we're going to have to move it either way, and there's going to be a cost, so that I'd like to find out more
from. Well, I think the presentation will inform us of that.
I don't think there's any question about the fact that if you put the console and bought it next week and put it in an existing area, and then you renovated the building and you had to move it again, there is going to be additional cost to do that.
There's no question, but it's a whole different system.
Whole different deal.
Right. It's a whole different deal.
And
but
it may be
again,
worth looking at. Right. And if that's the case, I would want to compare that cost to what it would actually cost to put it in the fire department to start here.
Well,
and if we had to move it.
Well, let's get
again, I think what you really want to get to is what exactly do we need right now?
Right.
And I think all the principals need to be involved in the same room with the expert, and then making the presentation to the board.
Yeah. Yep.
I agree.
Soon.
And then we can clear
this. Well, again, I didn't want to get into it, but
as far as the new police building, I mean, there's so much that has to go into that. We have to look at our debt service, where it fits in. So we can't, if this is something that's urgent, we can't be postponing it until we get a new police building. That's not going to...
I agree, I was trying to...
It's a nice leverage point. Oh, we can't do this until you build this new building.
Once you start adding this stuff up, it's a lot of debt service we're talking about right here.
Exactly, so... I think if this radio issue is as crucial and critical as you say it is, which I guess you're both saying it is, I think it's something we've got to deal with for getting the building.
So what do you think you can get that together for us?
Julie, give us a presentation.
Do you want to do a joint meeting like this?
I think you have to.
I think Tommy's got to take the lead on that.
He'll be working on it.
Why
tonight, Tony, if you can get that done tonight.
You mean Tony Anastasio?
I haven't. But I'll take care of it. Would you agree, Sean, I mean, since we have you here, would you agree, Sean, that having you come with the police department as well during this presentation would help us all ask our questions and understand it better so we can find out?
Yeah, I can only tell you what from the fire department side, this to us needs to be replaced, just like the radio system needs to be upgraded. Our sole concern, and I can't speak for the PD, but my sole concern is for firefighter safety. So if we have an issue with that, that needs to be addressed, and that's this board to come and tell you that this needs to be addressed and this is why it needs to be addressed. When it's obsolete and we don't know if she's still going to be able to get parts for it, like she said, that's a concern, and it's been obsolete because once something goes obsolete, you still get parts for it for 5 years. So that means it's been obsolete for a number of years, not just this year. And not to have anything in the budget for the next 6 years is showing to me that it's really doesn't need to be in the budget.
Well, I think it would be a capital project.
Yeah.
So I think the last time we did it a number of years ago, I was on that committee. It was a bond issue.
Yeah,
right.
And it was a bond issue, and that was many years ago. So, but I just think at this point, I don't think anybody at this table could really give us an explanation of exactly what we need to do. I can't. I mean, I hear you, but you're saying 1.7 million. I'm hearing 600,000. I'm hearing the console, but...
Well, that's just the console and the entire system.
So we need to get a... What do we need to do?
When do you want us to target having this big powwow?
Soon as possible.
Sooner than later.
I think it's got to be,
soon as possible.
We have to understand it.
You know, one of the concerns I have is that everyone who has talked about Julie as being incredibly knowledgeable and the person who can help us coordinate these also says she's very hard to understand.
Yeah.
So I think we might have to do a little vetting before Julie comes, because what we want to make sure is that we have the right translator here. We don't need another level of person where we're not clear. So I'm going to suggest maybe some pre-meeting, maybe somebody from Board of Selectmen, somebody from Board of Finance, and see if we can understand or if we actually need somebody else to explain it. Because if we're going to sit through something like this again with another person we don't understand, it's a big waste of time. So maybe Matt and I will follow up on that. I'd like to suggest we move along because we've spent a lot of time on this and we're not going to resolve it now. But I think everybody acknowledges and agrees it's very important that we get to an understanding.
I would also say, though, I'd like that Chief Marcucci, I'd like to hear from him.
Definitely.
It's fine to hear from Ray, but I think that the chief of police needs to weigh in on this also.
Yeah, I agree.
So is there anything else, Sean? I think we covered pretty much everything. Oh, the storage building, I'm sorry.
Storage building.
Well, we're riveted with excitement.
What happened?
It didn't grow.
Square feet now?
No.
170,000?
It never grew. It stayed the same. It's
and the
just
foundation is in. The foundation is in.
The foundation was in 4 years ago, and there wasn't enough money to finish the building. This would give us enough money to finish the and complete the project and be done with it.
Well, the truth of the story as it exists, we approved it. Board of Selectmen, Board of Finance approved it with an understanding that we were going to pay for the pad, just to get back, just to get some history, and the fire department was going to build the shed. They were going to put the labor out, and then we found out that can't work.
Sure.
So now you're talking about having somebody else build the shed.
Correct.
Okay, and that's what this is.
How big is the shed? How big is this building?
1,800 square feet.
And this also includes
the materials, because we ended up spending a little more than we thought on the base.
On the foundation.
So what was spent on the base, on the foundation? Do we know, Tony, what that?
Like 150.
Okay, so this is
$30,000 left in the budget.
$30,000 left. Yeah, 30. So if you combine that 30.
Foundation, we're on relief work.
So you have 30 left, so they only need 140?
I think you need the 170 with the 30, is that correct?
We need the 170 with the 30.
And so the 200 is therefore to pay for the actual building of it and the materials, because we don't have the materials either.
Correct.
Okay, so the next question comes, and you guys built a patio, and we almost had World War IV in Woodbridge. What's going to happen when you, I mean, is this thing just going to go up, or and people are going to start screaming, it's awful, it doesn't belong? I mean, what exactly are you going to build?
Well, it's already...
What rights do you have? Can you just put... I don't know.
We already have our permits.
I've seen the...
You do?
Okay. Well, it's already been approved.
I've seen the building.
The site, the look of the building roughly has been approved and everything else. It's basically just
plan,
a gable roof.
The actual plan of the building?
Yeah, we do.
Yeah.
That was...
I think Dwight...
All we're doing is we're changing basically the... We're going... Instead of just stick building it, which ended up being more, we ended up doing like a, more of a... barn type of construction where it's gonna you could put hardy plank on the outside, you could do pine on the outside, and you could blend into the back, or you could do hardy plank to match the building.
I just think you have to be sensitive to what
I area. I think this blends in a lot better because you could paint it whatever color, you can blend it right in, it could be the pine, it blends right in, and it's more of a barn type of look than per se.
Do you have inland wetlands approval for this?
Yes.
Yeah, it's, that's been done for the current footprint.
Yes.
Correct.
The base is already there.
Yeah, the patio. Okay.
Yeah. And what will you put in this building?
We have the Homeland Security trailer, the hazmat trailer, heat trailer, the hose. Basically, what the building was designed for, when we got the other building approved, the overflow was going to stay in the existing firehouse. Now that you want to move the rec department, the fitness center into the old firehouse, we're going to vacate those that room.
So it goes back to the fact that the new firehouse was built 5,000 square feet less than was needed.
Correct.
And so to compensate for that, the plan had always been to continue using, you know, a portion of the old firehouse for storage. And so the idea is to move the equipment that's in there now over to this new building, which frees up that bay in the old firehouse for
two bays for the fitness center.
We were occupying all three bays. We moved out of the far bay when you did phase one of the construction. We were bay one and bay two. We were able to cram it all in. Now what you're looking for is bay two and bay three is to be the rec center, so we have to vacate bay two. And bay one will still stay with the firehouse.
With the antique truck
in it.
Antique truck, but you're still going to use it for storage in addition to the antique truck? Because the thought was...
Just the one, yeah.
The original thought was to make that bay like a little firehouse museum, not to use it for storage. You would use it, obviously, for the antique fire truck, but that it would become a place that the public could actually access. You're saying no. You still need it for storage, even with this additional building.
Mm-hmm. And again, I just want to be clear. Just to avoid, as this thing goes up, there's not going to all of a sudden be people going nuts. What is this? Is there an understanding about what's going on?
We can speak to that by getting planned. You know, we could say what we want to go up there. I mean, I understand your concern.
Elias, you said that you have permits and plans for a particular... building?
We have a permit of plans for a three bay storage facility. That's what we have, and it's been approved.
So I guess my question is fundamentally: we're talking about this has been approved. So this board, we've approved the funding and everything. So I mean,
we didn't approve the funding. That's what this is for.
Right.
So we approved the pad. They were going to build the shed.
So now we have to approve.
We were going to provide the labor.
Right.
Okay. So now and for insurance reasons, we couldn't do that.
Right.
So now the issue is, do we want to fund $200,000 to build?
That's the issue.
Shed.
Right. And it's not clear to me that there is a current plan that has been presented and approved. It's just not clear.
Yes.
You have a final plan that you'd like to do, and that's already been approved by the board?
I'm a little confused. How much money has been spent to date?
$150,000
to date.
Yes.
And they need another $170,000 to complete this?
$200,000
to complete. Yes.
Yes. Well, they had $30,000 left, and the original was $180,000.
$180,000, correct.
Was originally funded $180,000. They spent $150,000 on the base, a little more than they originally thought. There's $30,000 left. They need another $170,000 to add to that $30,000 for the $200,000 they need in total for materials.
Let's also, we should also be clear. You know, we don't like to separate ourselves, but when we say we spent it, we didn't spend it. The fire commission, for example, and the fire department had really no control over that process. It was a town building committee. It came out of town hall. We want it. We're happy with it. We're putting it in our budget now, but it was never in our budget before, and it was a separate. A separate committee that was managing it. What we're doing now is asking for funding to build something that is cheaper than the original plan.
My recollection was the 180 was going to be the town's commitment to this.
Right, and it was the foundation
plus the materials.
Plus the materials. Right. It was everything. That was the commitment.
That's my recollection.
So they spent $150,000 of the $180,000. Mm-hmm.
No, you spent it, not they.
We spent
the project has
the project
utilized, $150,000 of the.
However, we want to say.
No, but Andy, when we voted on it, the $180,000 we voted on. I don't know, that was a number of years ago. Yeah, that was all the town was going to spend.
That's exactly right. I mean, I voted on it. I recall.
Right.
Now, this without
labor, right?
$200 a square foot.
Right.
Without labor.
There wasn't going to be any labor costs. There wasn't going to be any labor costs. So but this was going to be the pad plus the materials.
So when you say it's been approved, you mean you got building permits? Mm-hmm. TPs, I mean, who approved? What approvals? I mean,
Inland Wetland approved
it. We have a wetland.
TPZ approved it too. I think the Board of Selectmen actually had to approve it through TPZ.
Board of Selectmen approved it. I don't know if we
not an actual plan for a building.
Yes.
There was a plan.
Yeah, but they were just going to build the
foot. Correct. There was a plan.
No, there was a print.
There was a lot of hand, too, from
what I recall. There was a print. I have it. It's at the firehouse. Tony has it in the office, too.
I can't use your word. I'm not doubting.
Is this necessary? Do they need it?
They need more. They need it.
Well, you're going to have two skating rinks.
Yeah. So
maybe you don't need to kick them out of there.
Let me just and go to the old firehouse and what's being housed. The main reason for the shed, forget about space, and then someone will say, well, we can get trailer space. This particular space needs to be climate controlled.
Correct.
For the hose. And the hazmat trailer, I don't know if I'm calling it the right thing, but the hazmat trailer, those two things need to be, and other smaller items, need to be climate controlled.
Climate controlled.
And therefore, if not, it's not just a matter of space, is my point. We can't just go and put them in a trailer. We need space. So the idea of this shed is, and obviously the floor, I believe, is a heated floor. The whole idea of the shed is to be climate controlled.
Correct.
And that's how we would house these particular, those two larger items.
Correct.
Okay. But we're looking for a use for the old firehouse. We want to spend money on the old firehouse. Well, if they still needed the space to use, that building would have been is suitable to do that.
Yes.
Okay. We didn't have to spend $320,000 to build a shed. And they could have made it environmentally they can use it.
Suitable is, I would say it's barely suitable because...
Barely suitable?
Barely suitable because there are safety concerns with having to replace hose and running hose racks potentially across the street in the middle of the night. So it's far from a perfect situation.
Wait a minute. Hang on. I think we're getting off a little bit here. This was a project that was voted on by the Board of Selectmen, Board of Finance. This was not brought to the Board of Selectmen, Board of Finance by the fire department.
What are you talking about, the shed?
Yeah, we're looking to do right now is to finish a project that was started. This is the money that was appropriated.
We didn't initiate the project.
Well, no, well, because what it was is, well, actually you did, the actual board actually did initiate it. Because the board came up with a use committee. I think what was it called? The use committee for the old firehouse or the?
Yeah. It was committee on Cruff or something. I wasn't right. on that. Remember that?
And it
one?
Was and yeah, there was
Sandy
a committee. There was
you
a,
were on that. Yeah.
There was a committee designed. There was a committee designed to see ago. What to do with the old firehouse, right. and it was established at that point that it would make good use of to move the rec department out of the center school and put it over at the old firehouse, and then build a storage shed in back of the old firehouse. And actually, we actually had another committee look and see where it would make sense to put it on the property, whether it be at the new firehouse. At the old firehouse in the Cedar Grove, behind Pound Hall. So those options were all explored, and the best spot was in back of the old fire, in back of the new firehouse. And the town actually, Ed Sheehy, went to Inland Wetland and got the approval to put the shed in back of the new firehouse, and he was able to get them to sign on to do that. So this was not really orchestrated by the fire department, because We could stay in the old firehouse.
So we're not here to try and reinvent the wheel, but we see a problem, we want to try and solve it.
We started a project. We need to complete it.
I think there seems to be interest in sort of making sure if this is going forward, it's first of all the least expensive option. And I know I was at one building committee meeting where there was some discussion of trailers, heated trailers that might go on the slab that seemed like it was much less expensive. I don't know if that's something you've looked at or not. I mean, there may be something that's a different magnitude of money. I don't know.
Well, are we asking him to research that? Because we don't, I mean, I'm just trying to...
Do you really want temporary storage trailers?
I don't know the answer to that.
I mean, you know, I mean, we, the town's been trying to get rid of the ones in the flats for almost my entire lifetime. and you want to put, we don't, temporary storage trailers is not an appropriate solution for this.
Mm-hmm. I just thought it was discussed. I didn't know if you looked into it or what that.
No, it's a non-starter.
It was looked at like a Butler's type of building. That wasn't really a great idea. It was an all metal building. Because it wouldn't fit in with Woodbridge. There was multiple things looked into, and there were a lot of meetings and a lot of hours that went into all this. And this came to the Board of Selectmen. Actually, you guys actually had a meeting at the firehouse about it upstairs, and that's where I believe it was even approved.
Well, I think part of the disconnect here is the you guys part, because with the exception of Beth, I don't think any of the members of the Board of Selectmen existed then. I didn't.
Okay, well, I'm sorry.
The board of selectmen
at the time,
Sandy
or the administration
at the
time. I'm sorry.
Right.
So the board of selectmen may have been before me. So that's why I don't have a recollection of what the building actually looks like, because I know I was not on the board at that time.
Okay.
I don't actually know what we're talking about in terms of scope or scale, and that may be part of the disconnect here.
The town hired an engineer
to design the building. I totally
agree.
I'm not doubting anything you're saying.
Right. Sure, it's standard frame construction.
Yeah, she has
there
a
are
plans,
it. Or you can see.
Okay, so is it a one-story building, a two-story building?
It's a one-story building with like a loft, where there's a stairway to
so
go
it has
up
this
and there's
kind
storage.
Of
storage. Yes.
Yep. And yep. loft space.
Yep.
And how high up is that? 15 right. plus 15? The story is usually 15 feet.
No, it's the thing is like I want to say it's 10 foot downstairs, just underneath the beam. I want to say it's like 11 change, and then upstairs is it's a peaked roof with knee walls. So whatever the slope of the roof comes
up, it's about a half a loft.
It's probably like 11 and 7.
So it's really not, the building's 42.5 by 42.5, but upstairs isn't really 42.5 by 42.5. It's not like you have walls like this on the side. Only the center part is up.
So that peak is 8 feet tall, let's say. So it's 8 and 11. So it's a 20 foot tall building.
Yeah.
Roughly.
Yeah.
Give or take.
I have blueprints.
Yeah, but
white,
but
and I'm just saying,
we're here this second.
No.
Okay. So I'm just trying to get a sense of what the scope is.
Right.
Because
it's a gable roof.
I got you.
Okay.
And there's three garage doors.
I read.
Yep.
And then
there's a side entry door.
Okay. Thank you.
And there's a staircase that goes upstairs.
Thank you.
Inside that.
We did. I have them. That's why I was saying. I looked at mine and I read it. But
I think the difficulty
doesn't matter.
Some of us might be having, I know my dear friend Sandy is having, is that when we vote on a project, there was a lot of discussion about this.
Right.
A lot of people saying, you know, it's a brand new firehouse, it's the best building in town. We got to spend another $180,000. I remember it was a lot of discussion about, I don't think we should do it. We should do it. And finally, we decide, all right, $180,000, they'll build it. Well, now it's $300,000. $320,000. And so, in other words, in the middle of the game, the rules have changed.
Well, I appreciate.
I don't know that I would have voted for it if it was $300,000.
Except the rules changed because the rule was the fire folks were going to build it.
Right.
And I guess we all missed the step by figuring out whether that could be possible or not. And it turned out not to be possible because the town's insurance will disallow it. So I don't know that we can hang that over here.
It wasn't probably
easy. I mean, I don't know that that's right either.
Yeah.
I wasn't around. I'm trying to be objective, right? So
because that's construction, not firefighting.
It wasn't properly researched, maybe, as far as with the insurance.
I'm not assigning blame to anybody, but that's basically what happened. A step intervened, and that plan couldn't go forward for a legitimate reason that really is no one's fault. It just wasn't researched far enough.
I just think that if it was a $300,000 project, it would never pass.
Well, I guess that's true, but the issue now is...
I know.
Now we have a big slab, and... sitting
and
there.
And we have a budget. We have a tough budget year coming. And right. $170,000 to it.
Well, not only that, we have interconnection between the police department and the old firehouse because they're all connected.
And the fitness center.
So we need some strategic planning. We can't deal with one and not the other. These things all interconnect. So we have to have some discussions, I think, on all of these because just throw something out. If we went a different direction with the police department, whatever that is, and we didn't need to move recreation over there, they'd have some. I'm just throwing things. The point is, they're all connected, and we seem to. I don't want to get where we're dealing with one, and then it throws off something else. It's all impactful, but you know, these guys, if they need the space, we got to deal with. I don't know.
Well, again,
I don't want to spend the money either. But
the point is, you know, everybody has needs. The police department has needs.
Correct.
Recreation.
They just, you know, they roll out $2.5 million of capital equipment needs. Okay, that are musts. It's just adding up and adding up to millions and millions of dollars.
You okay? To the choir, because I'm.
This is it. This is it. Just.
I know. Our budget's too high.
So basically, there's needs and there's wants. Okay. Some way we have now to be. We're going to have to begin to distinguish, because we're getting up to the top of our borrowing.
Yeah.
Okay. We're going to have to distinguish between what a need is and what a want is.
I'm with you, and I think it crosses all the departments, not just here.
Oh, yeah.
I'm talking about all the departments.
I'm in for zero-based budgeting, to be honest with you. Let's look at all of them, because I agree with you totally.
We're up to the top of our borrowing.
We're right up past our eyeballs on this budget.
So
we have been for years. We can't.
Is it still possible both in the consideration of how this might go forward to take a look at, are we suggesting that we're looking at continuing to house the materials in the current old firehouse and therefore change that? Is that what's being suggested? Or just a matter of, is there money possible for this?
I'm talking about overall right now. I'm not specifically referring.
No, I know, but since they're here now, and I mean, obviously, this is what brought it to our attention. I'm just saying, what are we saying to them? What are we saying to each other about this part of the project? I mean, just kicking it down the road a few months and saying, well, we'll talk. Are we saying we'd like to reconsider whether or not it's even built?
I think we're going to have discussions.
It's going to be as the whole budget comes together.
This is just a presentation.
That's going to be determined.
Right. Then the selectmen will meet.
What I can tell you, there's going to have to be a lot of cutting to this capital budget across all lines.
And I think I'm just trying to be fair to them to say it may behoove them to take a look at what can be done, or at least alternatives to your plan.
My question is, how long do you want that slab to sit there unfinished? And do you really want to say to the taxpayers of this town that money was wasted? Because if you don't build it,
then
that money was wasted.
But there may be a 5-year plan, Lee. It doesn't have to be something that's
there's a limit to how long
that
can last there, too.
And that could be part of what you present. And we could, you know,
well, you've got heating equipment that's already been installed in it.
But it can last.
You've got things that are exposed to the elements and things that deteriorate over time. I'm not an expert in it. But I know that you know, you can't just let it, the longer you let it sit there, the raises more concerns.
I think that's a valid point. And my point of maybe you taking a look at it is that's the kind of thing that can be presented back to us as there's pros and cons. And certainly waiting has a negative effect on certain things as well.
And my point is that that's why Sean has come here, and we've come here with a proposal, okay, because it wasn't happening otherwise, and we say put it in our capital budget. Don't leave it to the town budget, the building committee budget, and consider this proposal, which will cost less than the original plan that was designed. So now we have we are proposing a less expensive building.
What's the thought here? Is the thought we don't want to? I mean, I know nobody not wants to do it, but what exactly do you want to research here? Do you want to research staying at the old firehouse? Do you want to research?
No. The decision is ours. Whether we can afford to fund what we've heard in the past 2 nights.
And I think the thought is to look at police, fire, recreation all together and say, what are the needs? What are the wants, as that's been put that way? And what are our options over a period of time? How do we want to play this out? So it's not a problem that you've brought this to these boards at all.
No, I'm not saying it's a problem. I'm just saying if you want me to do something, I don't really know what you would like me to research.
Here's the thing. We sit here, as the Board of Selectmen, the Board of Finance, and we weigh certain things, we listen to it. I mean, you came forth tonight, okay, and we had a conversation about this radio system that could be on the brink of failure, and we're talking about, you're telling us this thing completed is $1.7 million.
I'm saying the console is in dire need.
How much is the console?
$600,000.
$600,000, right? Mm-hmm.
The total 1.7 was by 2018.
Now, how do we, when we begin to define immediate, okay, I will tell you what, we don't have contingency funds for $600,000 for a console, okay? I mean, when we talk about these things, I mean, it's a $600,000. These are the things that upset our balance, okay?
But our concern with the $600,000 is a need to spend that on an emergency basis at some point. Well, I don't know whether that's this year, next year, 2 years from now, or when that's going to break down.
But it's a similar concern.
We need more clarity and more definition on
what the timeline is. Listen, we need to know what
all
that
I can listen. When I come up with my capital budget and even my operating budget, right? There's a lot of time that goes into this and it has to be researched. And I mean, I don't expect you all not to be 100% or knowing what the radio system can and can't do, what the life expectancy of the radio system is or isn't. But these are why we come here, and this is why we spend the time, and I come up with facts, and this is why I'm presenting to you here. This is what I believe the need is that we need to move forward. Now, does the radio console necessarily need to come out of the fire budget? No. But I can tell you that if the radio console goes down and fire dispatch goes down, I'll be the biggest one screaming, and then you're going to be having this conversation saying, why wasn't this in a six-year capital plan? That's what this is a six-year capital plan. So you're saying in 6 years, we're not showing a radio console in 6 years to be replaced.
But you just told me.
I'm saying I think it needs to be replaced now, and Julie believes it needs to be replaced now, and you've had a conversation with Julie because she mentioned that on the phone with me today.
I admitted that.
Now,
she said yes.
There's a lot of research that goes into it. Now, we could go back, and we could go back and forth. Now, I could bring all these people here and talk about this, but this is the best that I can do with you guys. I mean, unless we want to have a 45-minute powwow on a radio
system. We've heard two different scenarios tonight. You have to look at it from our position also. We've had two different presentations, two different scenarios.
But I thought we resolved that sooner rather than later.
We're going to clarify.
I'm saying we did hear two different scenarios.
Mm-hmm. Sure. In regards to the storage building, the way I look at it is we have the slab in, we have the foundation in, we need to complete the project or we need to abandon it. And we need to come up with another plan. Whether that means the fire department staying in the old firehouse and occupying Bay 1 and Bay 2 and moving forward that way, then maybe that's the way we need to go. But instead of just spinning our wheels, and I don't know if it's my wheels or somebody else's wheels or whatever, I think there just needs to be more of a group plan on what the, I understand the money end of it, what the group plan is for the whole see all end all is.
Your job and the job of all the departments is to tell us what you need, when you think you need it,
absolutely,
et cetera. Our job, like you were saying about the fire truck, you got your engine with seven or whatever. We didn't have any money put it. We figured out a way to pay for it.
Yeah.
That's our job. So if we decide not to fund the ladder truck, and at some point in time, we absolutely have to have a ladder truck, we're going to have to deal with how we're going to pay for this. Mm-hmm. But the question on an immediate need, such as a storage shed, we have to look at, we don't have the regular operating budget yet. Until we have that, we really can't make any decisions on this.
No, I agree with you.
So we'll have to decide at that point, can we afford $170,000 for a shed? And if we can't, regardless of the fact that the pad is there, we can't. We're not going to come in, we never come in with ridiculous budgets, and so things have to go. I mean, as a police department was sitting here, I'm thinking in my mind, you know, it's wonderful, but with our debt service, et cetera, there's no way that's going to happen this year. There's no way. It's impossible. So, you know, I go through these things as people are talking. Probably every proposal that comes through every department is valid. And it's a need or a want, as Andy said. We can't do it all. And we have to pick and choose and decide what's feasible. So you have to present us what you need. We have to decide whether we can do it this year, next year, or whatever.
I do have some pictures of what it would similarly look like without all the windows and everything, if you guys would be interested.
We're going to have to worry about the impact on the town. My purposes, it's behind your department. But there, you know, the uproar over building a patio, I want to make sure you guys don't get in any more confrontations. I don't know if people are expecting this thing to go up. Right now, they don't see anything there. So.
Well, and we would hope that it's not controversial because
you don't know.
We already went through the wetlands.
I hear you. On it. I hear you.
And so there was, you know, there was public input on that proposal, you know, way back when, and it's also behind the building, so it's not as as visible to people.
Okay.
We don't want it, you know, we still want it reasonably attractive.
So again, just understand our process. We have to look at the whole big picture. And until we finish the operating budgets, and then Tony and we'll all go through the capital budgets, and then that's when we decide, depending on the operating budget, how much capital we can come up with.
Sure, and just so as we understood the storage shed,
there's no doubt you need it.
It's part of the puzzle in terms of freeing up the space in the old building.
You need the space, you need the space. The question is whether we can come up with the money. Or anything else?
I think that's it.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Okay. Thanks.
Yeah. Sure. We didn't start it with anything.